folks, and welcome to the Gray Outdoors RV Company. My name is Tom, and today I have a very special edition for you. It's going to be the Cedar Creek Silverback Edition, the 37 RTH. Folks, I am super excited to show you this floor plan. This is something, man, as a guy that's looking for a toy hauler and you want a full coach and you don't need to have necessarily the full 10 or 12 foot garage, this is the perfect setup. As I demonstrated, you know, I had a fully dressed gold wing that just came out of the back of this thing. This is what the market has been yearning for, folks, and I'm super excited to show this one to you. First of all, this one's gonna be a triple axle for you. Okay, this is about a 42 foot long coach, but you're gonna get everything with the Cedar Creek Silverback models that have been built prior to this one. You're gonna get all aluminum substructure. You're gonna get the backing with the great insulation on it, the deck strap tools, the never adjust brakes. This coach is awesome, and I can't wait to show it to you. So because this is the very first floor plan in this particular model that I've had, I'm gonna actually kind of go into a little bit more length than what I have been in my previous videos. So first of all, the open space back here that you're gonna get, it's got a Jensen TV that pulls out and you can adjust it so you can put that in any angle that you want to, which is really kind of cool. You got some storage space up underneath here. You're also gonna have a 110 refrigerator. Now you got the slam latch doors on this coach. You got some outside speakers. You're gonna have a big awning that's got the metal wrap on it, so it's gonna protect your awning even when it's not deployed. The frameless windows. Let's not forget the way that these doors are held up here. So this is by a magnet, okay? And these magnets, they'll never wear or break on you or anything like that, unlike those little plastic clips that you see on a lot of the coaches. So this is all gonna come with the step above, the aluminum steps now on these coaches. They just fold right up inside. They travel this way, the door closes just like this. Bring the handle in and you're secure, ready to go down the road. So these aluminum steps are easy. You can adjust them right here with these little leg adjusters here. But getting in and out of this coach, more sturdy than they've ever been before. You're gonna have this coach is gonna be 5 slide outs. You're gonna have a wardrobe slide out in the bedroom, 2 opposing slide outs in the kitchen, and then you're gonna have 2 opposing slide outs in the front living room. Yes, this is a front living room coach. Folks, I am super excited to see. I've never had one like this before. I'm having a hard time even talking, trying to explain it to you, because when I saw this at the show in Indiana in August, I was like, guys, we have got to get one of these. This is the perfect setup for people that have just a single motorcycle, and like I said before, don't necessarily want the big open garage in a regular toy hauler. A couple of the other things that they've added is the spray port on the passenger side. Big pass-through storage. Now, you're also gonna get a large ottoman. We didn't take it out of the box, Octavio. You're slacking a little bit on me. No, but that's a great little addition to these coaches. It's an option, you can bring them in that way. You got your 230-pound propane tanks right here. We're gonna walk around the front. You're gonna see the gorgeous front fiberglass cap. Beautiful front on this coach. It's got the nice fiberglass gel cap on here. You're also gonna have LED lights, which is right here. Your fifth wheel components made by Lippert, which is a good product to have. Also, I wanted to point out on this coach, it's also got a 6-point hydraulic leveling system. Super easy to work. All you gotta do is hit a button. It'll level itself out in about 1 or 2 minutes. And it's also got auto truck memory to where it's gonna recognize exactly where you detach from. You hit another button, and it'll go right back down to the same hitch height so that you can hook up with ease. The dry weight on this coach is $13,595. The GVWR on this coach is going to be 18,000 pounds. And actually the tongue weight on this guy is actually pretty heavy. It's about 3,200 pounds. So I'm recommending at least a 1-ton vehicle to go ahead and pull this sucker down the road. You'll notice in here you got your battery compartment. You also have a residential refrigerator. It's going to work off an inverter right here. These are your components for your hydraulic slide outs and your auto level system. Also on your storage compartment, you'll have some internal controls here. You'll have another spray handle port. You'll have your battery disconnect. You'll have your city water and your tank fill. Your cable and your satellite hookups are going to be in here, and along with your bypass valves. All right, this coach is going to come with a 10-gallon direct spark ignition water heater, both gas and electric. And then what's really nice too is they actually give you an access port back behind your water heater. So if you need to get to a couple different bypass valves, you can definitely do that. You're going to have some more storage on the driver's side to the rear of the coach. These doors are just assisted with these shock springs that are on here, these gas springs. You can just close those. So this makes it really handy. You can put a lot of storage in this coach. And then of course, let's get to where all the magic happens, and that's in the garage. So you'll notice that how you can lock these handles on here. It's just a regular key on there. It's not a cheap device or anything like that. Regular key locks your garage into place. And then you can just open this guy. And what I really like about this, being that it's the toy hauler version, so guys with single motorcycles, maybe a golf cart, a four-wheeler, you can all get those in there. You got the 6-point tie downs that are also located in here. Now, when you load up your toys, this is actually gonna be your master bed that's in here. This thing just raises straight on up so that you can get the clearance to load all your toys, and the switch to raise that is gonna be located right here. You got the on-off switch for your lights back here. And then what I also like is going to be these specialty drawers that they put in here. So you can put all of your tools in here, anything that you might need that's gonna help you along the way for your trip. You gotta check this out inside. All right, well, this is the front living room of the Silverback 37RTH. It is gorgeous inside here, folks. We got the fireplace going. I had to pay Octavio to plug this thing in and get it warm in here, because I'm a sissy when it comes to the cold. But yeah, this is cranking pretty good. You'll notice that this front living room is going to come with two opposing couches. It's also going to come with some theater seating that you're going to have over here. And what's cool about this as well is, say for instance you want to have some people that are going to come with you on your little trip, these two opposing couches here actually turn into a bed. And I'm going to show you this on this one really quick. And now you have a second and possibly a third bed if you need it, for sure. You'll notice the beautiful trim that's in this coach. Gorgeous colors. Put this back. So it doesn't take long to set this up, folks. You'll notice too that on the Silverbacks, you're gonna have the pull-down shades. Nice little touch to that. But let's talk about this cabinet space that you have over here in the front. You get a 110 power outlet right here. You got some cabinets here. Big storage up underneath here, both sides. You have a Jensen stereo, CD, DVD player, Bluetooth capable, your Jensen sound bar, all gonna be located essentially right here. Big 50-inch screen TV. Man, if you can't have a party in this thing, I don't know what to tell you. Let's check out the kitchen area, because I think you're gonna love it. So you'll notice right away, with the Silverback, you're gonna get a residential fridge in here. It does run off the inverter. You guys saw that on the outside when I was demonstrating where the battery compartment was. So that inverter will keep you nice and cold going down the road. Just turn that little guy on and it'll switch your 110 over from your 12 volt. Residential grade microwave, of course. You have a Suburban 3-burner stove, oven, tons of cabinet space. You got lots of pull-out drawers here.
here as well. And then this is a pull-out drawer too. You can easily put your trash can underneath there. But what I really like what they're doing in this coach is on the pantry, you can pull these drawers out. And what's really nice too is you notice that there's a 110 power outlet back here. This is great. So if you're a coffee drinker and you have a Keurig machine, maybe a toaster or something like that, you can put that right here. Don't have to worry about cluttering up your counter space. Just use it when you need it and put it away. Right here is going to be your command center. Got some shelves here. This is an area where you can kick your slide outs, your awning. You do have a technology information portal here. Everything is, now it's all going digital, folks. So all you gotta do is troubleshoot. You can do all that from this little component right here, above cabinets. And then right behind you, oh, let's talk about the sink. Let's not forget about the sink, Octavio. Stainless steel sinks. You got the hard surface coring countertops that are on here. This sink pulls down so you can spray your partner if you'd like. And then let's go over here to the dinette. So the dinette is beautiful. Four chair dinette, and this guy pulls out. So if you need more room, does come with a leaf insert. But you can easily sit up underneath here. Beautiful, got plenty of room in here. Pull down shades all throughout. Beautiful wood trim that's in here as well. So let's go check out the bathroom and the bedroom. So the bathroom is very open and spacious. You'll notice that you almost pretty much have a residential shower in here. Being 6'2", you can see how much headroom I have in here. And the shower is at normal height that you would see at a residential shower in your home. You got the 3-door enclosure here. Plenty of cabinet space for all of your toiletries. You got a sink here. Medicine cabinet. You even have a max air fan that's in here too, that's also on a rain sensor. So you can turn that on, brings a nice cool breeze to the camper, will close automatically when it detects rain. And then of course you have a foot flush Dometic toilet. And I can sit down to kind of give people the perspective so they're not hitting their knees or anything on their cabinets. Cabinet space underneath the sink is plentiful. GFI breaker, towel holder here. So very, very spacious bathroom on this 37 RTH. Let's check out the master bedroom. Oh, look, Tara left her little stuffed animal in here. Well, welcome to the master bedroom of the 37 RTH. So you'll notice that this bed is a little raised for you, and this is where your garage system is going to sit. And the reason that the button to raise this up and down is in the garage is because you want to be able to make sure that you're not damaging any of your toys underneath. You want to make sure that you have enough clearance. You can't do that from in here. So putting the switch down in the garage is the best place to put it. So when you do lower the bed, you know that you're not going to break your toys, and then you'll be able to lower this down successfully without damaging anything. So that's the reason that they do that. Look at all the cabinet space that you have in here. This is awesome. The wardrobe slide out. It's a small little slide out, but you'll notice you got a couple sitting areas right here by the window. You're also gonna notice a sitting area right here too at the foot of the bed. So this will help you, you know, put your shoes on and just chill out for a little bit. You have a TV here, cabinet for hanging clothes, and then let's not forget the washer dryer hookup in here. And you can easily put a stackable washer dryer in here without a problem, that's for sure. Get the beautiful trim wood look in here that accents the bedroom beautifully. Lots of space. You can get that, Octavio. Pull out drawers. So lots of space and lots of room in this master bedroom. Okay, so one of the things I wanted to show you too before we close this video is I actually loaded the bike back into the garage area. Now again, this is a fully dressed Honda Goldwing, fully loaded touring bike, and you can see with the bed down, I actually have a lot of clearance in this bed, and that's with my windshield up, okay? So Harley Davidsons, the bigger bikes, they will all fit in here, folks. You can lower the bed back down in here, and again, to raise this guy up, it's just a simple push of a button is all you're looking to do. But the good thing about it is that you can leave your bike in overnight,
bring your bed down, know that your toys are gonna be safe, they're not gonna go anywhere, they're protected from, you know, the elements. So the bed's all the way up, you bring it back down just like this. Bike is safe and secure. Lock the door and you'll be on your way. All right, folks, thanks for joining me on the tour of the 37 RTH Cedar Creek Silverback model. I love this floor plan. I love the concept. I love the fact that it's a toy hauler. I love the fact that it's a front living room. And I really want to sell this one to you for sure. If you have any questions on this particular coach, pick up the phone and give me a call, 970-313-4337. Or if you want to shoot me an email, that's fine too. I got one of those. It's Tom at thegreyoutdoorsrb.com. And hopefully I'll be seeing you on my lot very soon.